$25 per credit. That translates to $141,000 that the State Advanced Opportunities Program has covered. However, had these students not had the opportunities offered at Compass for the dual credit program, at the typical rate of $380 per credit, if they would have waited until college, would equal $714,780 that they have saved. You're welcome, parents. Therefore, as you walk across this stage and receive your average-looking diploma in a typical-looking cover, just know that the one with Compass Honors High School written on it stands out above the rest. It means that you are truly prepared for next level excellence. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Connor Christensen.
And my name is Logan Clark.
And we are your class of 2022 salutatorians. We are honored to stand before you today and talk about our past experiences here at Compass. These past couple of years have been difficult for many people. We experienced a lot of uncertainty and at certain times. But there are also so many amazing things that we're able to accomplish throughout our high school career. Despite what was going on in the world, we found a way to live our lives to the fullest.
When we all started high school, we were just little kids. We had not yet grown into our bodies. With our squeaky little voices, we started the journey of high school. I always remember school like it was going to be the best thing ever. My elementary self looked in awe at high schoolers as it walked through the halls. When my brother was a senior, I'd never be that cool or mature, but I like to think we are. Maybe not. Little did we know that this high school experience would be something that would help shape us into the people that we are today and in the future.
First, it started with freshman year. We charged into high school, feeling nervous and not knowing what to expect. Along with our parents, we spent the prior day and weeks school shopping, trying to gather all the supplies on the list. The night before, we laid out our first day of school outfit. We were hardly able to sleep, knowing that the next day would be the first day of high school. We were excited, but nervous. As you know, we were the fresh meat for all the upperclassmen. We looked at the seniors and thought, wow, I just can't wait to be a senior.
Next was our sophomore year. This was the first year at our new campus where we are standing today, or sitting, I guess. That year, we felt a little bit more comfortable. At this point, we had a year of high school under our belts, and we had our own new building to break in. We were beginning to feel like big kids. By this point, many of us had learned how to drive and got our driver's licenses. As we drove ourselves to school, we were beginning to taste that sweet independence. But we still kept saying, I can't wait to be a senior.
Sophomore year would fly by in a blur. And before we knew it, we were walking into our junior year. Now, we truly began to feel like ourselves. We had two whole years under our belts. At this time, we already considered ourselves the best of the best. In fact, we were now upperclassmen. We felt like we could take on the world by ourselves. Many of us began to bump heads with our parents, thinking that we already knew what was right and wrong. This is where we started to form our own personal worldview. With great anticipation, we finished up our junior year, still saying, I just can't wait to be a senior.
But just like that, in the blink of an eye, we finished our junior year and headed into our senior year, our final year of high school. We had three whole years of experience under our belt. We were now the top dogs. We ruled the school. We became what everyone else wanted to be. All the hard work that we had put in for many years was now paying off. At this point, many of us began to decide what we would do in our future. For some, it was college or vocational school. For some, it was the military. And some of us had no real clue what we wanted to do yet. As we neared the end of our senior year, sentiment started to sink in. We began to say, I just wish I could be a freshman again.
Growing up can be a scary thing, full of unknowns and uncertainties. But growing up is the inevitable event of our lives. We shouldn't be scared to grow up, because here at Compass, we have developed skills that don't just turn us into good students, but into good people. People who help their community, who work to change the world for the better, who strive to help those in need. We are individuals of high character, represent what it means to be good citizens. We can graduate knowing that what we've developed here at Compass will make us successful in our future aspirations. I would consider us overprepared. I know that through any trial and tribulation, we will stand firm in the world. I know that in anything that we pursue, we will achieve to our full potential. No matter what life throws at us, we will overcome. I will leave you with this quote from Norman Vaughn. Dream big and dare to fail.
Thank you and best wishes, class of 2022.
Hello and good morning. My name is Luke Birkenmeyer.
I'm Ella Nolan.
And I'm Sophia Borders.
And we are class of 2022 valedictorians. First, we would like to thank the board members, administration, teachers and faculty, family members, parents, friends, and fellow graduates for being here today.
We'd like to give a very special thank you to every single teacher we've ever had at Compass. The best part about Compass is how the teachers truly care about us as individuals and work to build relationships with us. At Compass, you're not just another brick in the wall. Teachers, your students will be eternally grateful for your dedication, not only to our education, but to our personal success.
Another huge thank you to our family support systems. Whether you're a parent, grandparent, aunt, uncle, cousin, older sibling, or friend that is family, we wouldn't have been able to make it through high school without your constant love and support.
Fellow graduates, congratulations. Graduating from Compass is no small feat. The academic rigor here requires a strong work ethic and a growth mindset. Looking around this room, I'm reminded of something the comedian John Mulaney said. It's so much easier not to do things than to do them. That you would do anything is totally remarkable. Percentage-wise, it is 100% easier not to do things than to do them. And so much fun not to do them, especially when you're supposed to do them. Over the past 4 years of high school, did we want to do all the things we were supposed to? No. And it would have been a whole lot easier not to do them at all. But we did them, and it's completely remarkable that now here we sit or stand with these
class of 2022's reputation preceded us. The teachers were talking about us before we even entered the classrooms. We were well known for our study habits, our behavior, and our work ethic. Everyone knew about the class of 2022. Sounds like a downright respectable group of students. It was not a good reputation. We were not just well known, we were infamous coming into high school. Our study habits were lacking, our behavior was not the greatest, and our work ethic,
not to name any names, but even one of the valedictorians had an affair with procrastination.
As much as we joke, it's important to know where we came from so that we can recognize how far we've come. Now, as we graduate, every single one of us can be proud of ourselves for how much we've grown. As we've said before, being a Compass graduate is a big deal.
Where we were as freshmen 4 years ago is incomparable to where we stand or sit now. We have learned from our mistakes and developed skills essential to college, the workforce, and life in general. But every high school is designed to prepare you in different ways. Having educational skills only gets you so far in life. There are so many more important things to know.
As Compass has taught every one of us, skills dwarf in comparison to the importance of a worldview. For those of us in Mr. Jacobs' class, we know what a worldview is. For those that do not know the Compass definition, a worldview is a strong foundation to stand on for all the decisions that we will make in our lives. It defines truth and sets standards for our own belief system. For the three of us personally, our worldview comes from our Savior, Jesus Christ. But whatever your worldview may be, it is imperative that you have one. One that will stand against the chaos, confusion, and turmoil of the real world. A world's doors we will walk into for the first time as we walk out of these doors for the last time.
Whether you are in the workforce or raising a family, external motivation is a driving force, but you should always strive to make yourself proud. For me especially, I had always had the goal to become valedictorian. But it really hit me when, in the summer before my freshman year, I was at the golf course with my dad, and he said that nothing would make him prouder than for me to become valedictorian. So I grinded, and I sacrificed, and I tried so hard to become valedictorian, and now I'm here. Along with the pride of my parents, I still have the pride of a feeling of accomplishment deep within my heart. Whatever your goals are, you must too sacrifice and work to achieve the goals to add the pride to your heart and those around you. Always strive to achieve your goals and never give up, no matter the hardships that you face. As the legendary Rocky Balboa once said, going in one more round when you don't think you can, that's what makes all the difference in your life. Strive to achieve your goals and don't stop until they're finished.
Achieving such goals in life doesn't come easy. I'm going to be honest and say something that we already all know. Life is tough. It is going to knock you down over and over again. It'll slap you in the face. It'll kick you while you're down. But through all of that, just remember, never die. It's okay to lose, to die, but don't die without trying, without giving it your best. That's a quote from one of my personal heroes, Chicago Bears running back, Walter Payton, but it is actually some of the best advice that I've ever heard for life. It's a tough realization that you're not going to be perfect at everything. What matters is not dying easy. Not dying easy is more than just not giving up. It's refusing to run out of bounds. It's putting your head down and pushing. It's fighting. No matter what you do in life, do it with all that you have. Fight for it. After all of that, if you still lose, it's okay. You can learn from that. But you'll never learn if you never fight.
With that being said, we have fought the fight that is high school, and we won. Now we're on to greater things. Growing up, my dad always told me, today is the first day of the rest of your life. Now take a minute to think. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. I heard this for the first time as a five-year-old, and as you might imagine, I puzzled over it for quite some time. Now I understand it more than ever, and it's never been more true than it is today, not only for me, but for every single graduate in this room. But no matter what age you are, today will always be the first day of the rest of your life. Today is your chance to make a new beginning, accomplish something great, and learn from mistakes. So my question to everyone in this room is, graduates and adults alike, what are you going to do with the first day of the rest of your life?
Congratulations, class of 2022. And now, we would like to honor our parents and mentors who have guided us through these past years. Graduates, please select your flowers and show your appreciation to those who have supported you. Thank you.
May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
We would now like to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Cosio. He taught the graduating class of 2022 since 2017. He has always been caring for his plants and other people, optimistic, sincere, imaginative, and open-hearted since the beginning of his career, and has always been a class favorite to us all. Mr. Cosio has not only taught many students, but been there to guide them and help them through their lives. He's not only been a mentor in the subject of Spanish alone, but through high school as a whole.
His classes were filled with fun, very fun and engaging activities. His classroom was a relaxing environment, but an educational one too. He used his positive personality to relate with the students by asking them how their day was every single day. After some time, we got comfortable enough to where we even created an underground trading system for his in-class currency. He constantly encouraged students to live their best lives and was always there for us when we needed someone to talk to. Eventually, he did move on from Compass. And everyone, even teachers, need to graduate. So we are very excited to see him again.
With this being said, we are very excited to say, welcome back, Mr. Cosio.
Fouts, Evan, thank you so much for that introduction. I really do appreciate it. I will say, creating an underground economy is hands down one of the best accomplishments I've ever done in my life. Nothing will ever trump that. Parents, families, teachers and administration, class of 2022, good morning. For those of you who may not know me, I am Brian Cosio. From fall of 2016 to spring of 2021, I was the high school Spanish teacher, as well as the middle school Hispanic culture teacher at Compass. It was during the fall of 2016 that you graduates were starting middle school and our lives crossed. Class of 2022, can you please raise your hand if you were in Spanish culture class in seventh grade? How about if you were in Spanish one in eighth grade? Spanish in ninth grade, keep your hands up. 10th grade and 11th grade. As you can see, we've been through a lot during our time at Compass. Me being hungry and irritable every single day of Spanish culture. Lots of crying on your parts during middle school. End of semester flea markets where a betta fish was auctioned off. Holding a funeral for said betta fish months later. May Pablo rest in peace. Transforming our classroom with flexible seating and countless class discussions. This is all to say I had the opportunity to see you grow from swirly, and in my opinion, very annoying middle schoolers, to young adults ready to take on the world. When I got the news that I would be your graduation speaker, I knew this was no small task. Ms. Stevens informed me that the goal of this speech was to offer valuable tips to the graduating class, while also uplifting. If you spend any time around teenagers, you learn very quickly they have an impressive talent for zoning out any adults that is even remotely near them. Parents, I'm sure you've experienced this many, many times. Pretty soon, I learned I can use this to my advantage. You see, as soon as you are invisible to a teen, you become privy to the hilarious and oftentimes really weird things they say when they think adults aren't listening. Graduates, over the last few years, I've taken advantage of my invisibility to eavesdrop on your conversations during class and collect my favorite quotes. Today, I would like to share 5 of these quotes and the wisdom I have gleaned from each. Now, there's 2 possible reactions right now. If you're a graduate, you're probably hoping like, oh my gosh, I hope I make it in the speech. If you're a parent of a graduate, you're thinking, oh my gosh, I hope my kid doesn't end up in the speech. Let's find out. The first quote I'd like to share, and one that really speaks to my soul, comes from Hunter Mezzo. I never distance myself from food. Hunter's message is immediately obvious. One should never skip a meal. However, upon closer examination of Hunter's words, it becomes clear there is so much more to unpack beyond making sure you nourish your body. You should also never distance yourself from your own needs. In other words, put yourself first. Putting yourself first means finding hobbies that bring you joy, surrounding yourself with a supportive community, and setting boundaries. While it sounds simple, learning to take care of yourself in mind, body, and soul takes immense practice. So I encourage you to practice daily. Set time aside each day to do things that bring you joy. For me, that means riding my bike after work and watching Saturday Night Live reruns every Sunday morning. Find whatever that may be for you. Spending time with friends, working out, making art, napping, and make it a regular part of your life. I promise you'll lead a more positive life as a result. Now that Hunter has helped you understand the importance of taking care of yourself, I'd like to share your quote about somebody doing the complete opposite. Abby Arnzen once exclaimed, "Wait, I'm allergic to adhesive." I know what you're thinking. Abby's clearly taking really good care of herself. Look at how she's communicating her health needs. Well, let me provide some context. Abby once exclaimed, "Wait, I'm allergic to adhesive," immediately after using a glue stick as lip balm. See what I mean? Abby, homie, you're not taking care of yourself. You and Hunter should probably talk after this. Actually, Abby is showing us that every action has a consequence. Sometimes, like an allergic reaction, which fortunately, Abby, you didn't have, consequences can be immediate. Other times, the consequences arrive much later. For example, 3 years later at your high school graduation. Either way, anytime you are making a decision, you are also choosing to accept its consequences. I'm not here to teach you about right versus wrong. You have the free will to do whatever may be right or wrong for you. But I am here to teach you to always weigh the consequences of your actions. For most of the decisions you make, the outcome will be inconsequential. But for a few decisions, the decisions in life that really matter, ask yourself, will I wake up tomorrow and be happy with the consequences of my decisions? What about a year from now? 5 years from now? If the answer continues to be yes, then you know it's a decision that you're ready to make. If the answer is no, well, you can see where this is going. So whenever you have a decision to make, no matter how big or small, I hope you think back to Abby's words, "Wait, I'm allergic to adhesive." And they guide you to whichever option and outcome is best for you. Life is not only full of countless decisions, it also requires us to ask a lot of things, such as asking a crush out on a date, asking for a raise or promotion at work, or help when you are in need. An example we can all learn from came from Jesse Summers when he stated, "Swiggity swaggity, give me that translation." Let's take a moment to admire Jesse's confidence. Jesse, I remember you were in 9th grade sitting in the front of a room when I asked you and your classmates to translate a word into English. You didn't even bother to look through your notes. You didn't even bother to pretend to think of the word. You just went for it and you asked. That's honestly really impressive. Now the best part is I gave Jesse the translation. I didn't even ask him to look it up, to try a little bit harder. I just gave him the word. You see, Jesse has it figured out. When you ask for something, you have absolutely nothing to lose and everything to gain. So ask away. In Jesse's case, the worst case scenario was that he would have learned something in school? Wow. Now, I'll be the first to admit, we can't all be like Jesse. Advocating for your needs can be challenging. I struggle with it daily, but when I have advocated for myself, I've had some pretty awesome results. For example, I received a scholarship for several thousand dollars in college just by walking into a professor's office and asking. Or, I once got a job simply by texting an acquaintance and asking about any openings at his work. No interview necessary. What helped me have the confidence to ask for a job or a scholarship was knowing that the worst possible outcome was being no, being told no, a price that I was more than willing to pay. Graduates, I hope that you remember Jesse's words, swiggity swaggity, give me that translation, throughout your life, and they give you the confidence to advocate for yourself like they have for me. Speaking of words worth remembering, the next quote I want to share with you is without a doubt the best piece of feedback I have ever received. Eli Hodson once told me, Mr. Cosio, you're a horrible adult. You're like a kid. Eli, where are you? Thank you. From the bottom of my heart, it really is one of the best things I've been told. Unfortunately, we're so focused on growing up and the freedom that comes with adulthood that we forget how precious childhood is until it's too late. I'd like to confess something to you. Being an adult kind of sucks. All the freedom you were looking forward to, it's so expensive. Do you know how much an avocado costs right now? It's absurd. Did you also know they don't make light-up shoes for adults? At all, like it's super bummer here. So my suggestion, don't grow up. You have a lifetime of adulthood waiting ahead of you, and with each passing day, more of your childhood is behind you. So while you still can, don't take yourself too seriously. Play, be a kid, and make a conscious choice to carry that energy into adulthood. And then, whenever your responsibilities seem too heavy to bear, revisit that childhood energy. For me, laughing more and laughing authentically is something I remember doing often as a child. So as an adult, I find as many reasons to laugh or cackle, as some of you called it. It's made me happier, healthier, and more aware of surrounding myself with positivity. I would like to end with a quote that teaches not just a lesson to you graduates, but to everyone in this room. Joey Ruiz, as a commentary on the way you perceive others, said, "Hot guys don't poop." Before I continue, I need to apologize to all the hot guys in the room. The gig is up, dude. You all know. Just like the rest of us, you poop too. Now let's cut the crap, people. Joey's words serve as a reminder that we are all guilty of comparing ourselves to others and believing that we are less than or somehow less worthy of happiness than them. I would like to make two things clear. You are incomparable. You truly are one of a kind. There never has been, nor will there ever be, someone who comes close to being you. And number two, you are worthy of everything you hope and dream, no matter where you come from, what you look like, what you believe, who you love, how you identify, or any other factor in the world. Next time you find yourself starting to unfairly compare yourself to others, stop and remember that we are all deserving of dignity, happiness, and success. And that just like the rest of us, hot guys do in fact poop. Graduates. In a few moments, you will receive your diploma, leaving behind one chapter of your lives, and your lives in the world. Since I met you in seventh and eighth grade, you were ready to take on the world. So I don't wish you luck. It's the world that needs it. In this room, we have athletes, artists, leaders, and thinkers that will propel our community into a bright future. I am honored to have been your teacher and to help set you on to it. Class of 2022. I hope you have a wonderful day. Be good people, make good choices, and do good things. Thank you.
Cole Anderson. Emily Jane Argon. Abigail Marie Arnson. Macy Marie Aberzetti. David Mark Barnes. Cade Joseph Bateman. Wyatt Matthew Bird. Luke David Birkenbaum. Sophia Joanna Borders. Alexis Castillo Blandin. Connor Bailey Christensen. Logan Chad Clark. Lucas Cole Cordero. Micah Clement David. Nicholas Valeri Druliard. Lauren Marine Failer. Elise Rochelle Folk. Wesley Tate Foreman. Lucas David Fouts. Evington Rodney Frank. Addison Ray Frisch. Sophia Elizabeth Holst. Elijah Michael Hudson. Judah Christian Howie. Carter Allen Malm. Ashley Elizabeth Merrill. Hunter Michael Mezzo. Ella Peyton Nolan. William Robert Pensinger IV. Riley Alicia Rayborn. Felix Diego Rivera. Joel Matthew Ruiz. Kellett Andrew Shambora. Spencer Quentin Shaw. Thomas Lee Schrader. Jesse Tarl Summers. Avery Schuyler Vaughn. Peyton Marshall Wiebe. Kayla Melody Wing. Chloe Pordahl Young. I present to you the class of 2022.